Stewart. Gavin Stewart's four field goals this evening, most by a Georgia Tech kicker since Harrison Butker, who's now the starting place kicker for the Kansas City Chiefs in the 2016 Tax Slayer Bowl against Kentucky. So we'll go ahead and open it right up for questions for Gavin. Kelly?
Obviously, you've been out, hadn't played the last couple games, and you get the call this week. Kind of, what was the conversations like with Coach Key? What was the competition like going into this week to get ready?
Yeah, no, so I ended up getting injured. I ended up coming back this week thanks to the training staff for getting me back healthy. I thought I was going to be out for a little bit longer. But just as far as competition. Coach Key would talk about it, and I was going to get an opportunity this week, and I capitalized on it.
And do you know how it was determined? Was it in the week of practice, or did you know going in, or how did it?
Oh, it was just kind of going to the week of practice. Yeah, just week of practice. Yeah.
So it was the week's practice that determined.
Yeah.
Kind of getting that first one, kind of get things going. I know you guys. It's been, you know, since you've been here, it's kind of been hit and miss. Did that give you the confidence to get the first one through and kind of get that lead?
Oh, yeah, no, definitely. The first one, I was pretty nervous. I don't really remember that much. I just remember looking up and going in. So, I mean, that's definitely a confidence booster, like, for a kicker. The first ball of the game, or the first ball in a long time that I've kicked live. It's just a good feeling to see it go through, and it kind of gives you that extra confidence to go out there and, like, do the same thing and kind of calm your nerves. And more like it's just practice again. But.
Anything else? Kind of.
Were you guys coached differently at all this week?
Different.
Yeah, well, like, was your routine different, or?
As far as special teams, or just
right,
like,
you like the kickers, the place kicking.
I mean, no, not really. Mm-hmm. I mean, I wouldn't say anything different. I mean, as y'all saw today, I mean, we did put a new like punt scheme with the shield, so that was kind of a big change up front for us. But I mean, as far as that, Coach Key loves to do like a lot more special teams, like teaching periods and stuff like that. So that definitely helped us in special teams. Practice was really big, so all that changed.
Back here, and then Kelly, and we'll wrap up with Kevin.
If my math's right, I believe you made two field goals prior to tonight.
Yes.
So, what was it like, the workload, and, you know, kind of having to stack these? Any nerve?
Do you mean two field goals, like?
Yeah, out tonight. Yeah, prior to, and then you just doing what you did tonight.
Yeah. I mean, it has been a while, so it was good to be, like, get back there on the field and everything. I mean, going out there tonight, man, it's a very big accomplishment. Go look back at it. I mean, very proud of what we all did tonight. I mean, kind of the world was against us at this point. I mean, everything that happened in one day, and having to come together as a team, realize what our purpose is, and who knows what happens tomorrow, like, coach, whatever it is that season, you know, we all need to buy in and figure out what we need to do now and kind of further go about the season and succeed and
improve. A lot of rain. Weather wasn't here.
Yeah.
What was that like?
Going out there, I mean, it was raining. We thought the wind was going to be a lot worse. I'm kind of scared for that. But, I mean, it doesn't change anything you do operationally as a special teams and sure for offense defense. But, yeah.
Can I wrap this up with Gavin?
Coach, he talked about kind of having that mentality of winning the game and not being, you know, wondering what happens next and waiting for the bad things to happen. Was that something that was tangible for you guys today that you felt confident throughout the whole game?
Oh, yeah, definitely. I mean, it's play-by-play, week-by-week. I mean, you can't look 2 weeks in the future. You have to, as he says, you have to win every part of your day. And if you're not doing that, you got to start rethinking your whole mind process. And whether it's waking up in the morning, practice, getting on meetings all the time. Like, really kind of brought that upon us this week. And I feel like that definitely brought us a good little attitude going in this game.
Okay, thanks, Kevin. Appreciate it. Okay, quarterback Jeff Sims, we'll go ahead and open it right up for questions for Jeff. Kelly?
Jeff, obviously it's a very physical game and with the weather and stuff. Do you feel like that maybe impacted the passing game in the first half for you guys, just the wetness of the field and all of that? And then, you know, what did you get going in the run game in the second half?
We just made a big emphasis on going out there and playing hard, and because the defense was balling out, they was playing hard, and they was giving us plenty of opportunities. So the offense, we just came.
mentioned there being more attention to detail in practice. Could you give an example of maybe something that was different in terms of, you know, the way you were practicing and the way you had to practice?
I mean, it's not really that big of a difference in practice. It's just more work, you know, everybody. It's really the players, you know. We came up with that, and just Coach Key's been harping on the player-led team. And he's been on us to get the team going as players and lead the team in the right direction, and we focus on working this week, you know, not playing around and not doing anything that's not going to help us win, just staying focused in practice and going out there and giving it all we got, like, win the game.
Okay. Thanks, Jim. Appreciate you. Okay, linebacker Charlie Thomas. We'll open it right up for questions for Charlie. Kelly?
Again, what was going through your mind? You're sitting on the sideline in the first half. It's a real dogfight. You guys are playing hard. And then you come out and you're on fire in the second. Just kind of what we do that.
I just wanted to play for my guys. They were playing for me in the first half, so I just wanted to show that I was going to do the same for them in the second half. I just appreciate them. I love my team, so I just feel like we're playing for each other out there.
Ken?
Can you tell us what it was like to find out that Coach Collins had been let go, and then kind of how, like, your emotions throughout the week?
It was definitely, like, different, like, in anything I experienced in college. I feel like we just embraced each other more. Like I said, like, I feel like it made the team each other closer. Like, it was just kind of different.
Anything else? Kelly?
You got the pick.
I kind of missed the tackle on the fumble, and then the ball was there. I was like, oops, and I just picked it up. I ended up running out of stamina. I couldn't finish it, but I wish I would have gotten the end zone for sure. And then on the interception, that's just repetition and practice. We practice that all the time. And it just happened to come to my hand, and I caught it.
Did you get it one-handed? Or did you get
it? It was definitely two-handed. Yeah.
Kelly.
I'm
sorry.
How are things different this week in the way that Coach Key ran things?
We just focus on ball for real. It wasn't that different. We just focus on ball. We don't worry about all the extra stuff, all the extra stuff. Like, we just focus on winning football games. Whatever it takes to win football games, that's what we just focus on.
Kelly.
Coach Key talked about wanting to simplify things, just let you guys play fast. Was that part of the game plan today? Maybe take a few things that are not due quite as much and let you guys just fly to the ball and let it rip?
I think that has something to do with it.
Is there anything tangible, like, you can talk about from maybe something, you know, where they just get the plays in quicker to you guys? Anything in particular that kind of stood out to you?
For the most part, it's really like, if we was confused with anything, we should let it know, the coaches know, and then, like, they might not call that as much.
Thanks, Charlie. All right. Last but certainly not least, linebacker Ace Sealy.